David Attenborough proved that age was just a number when he impressed the green planet crew with his rowing skills during filming. The environmentalist, 95, showed off his stamina when he insisted on rowing himself back across a Croatian lake after shooting scenes for the show which aired on Sunday. David had been visiting the World Heritage Site of Falling Lakes in Plitvice and after exploring the area and its vegetation, refused to let show bosses row him back. Show producer Mike Gunton told The Mirror, "I was with him in the boat, partly because I'm directing him but also because he's out in the middle of the lake and I've got to be careful that nothing goes wrong. So I actually rowed out to the location, to where we were doing the filming, and then he took over. When Wed got the shots, I said okay David, we've cut now. He'll get in and he'll row us back." He said, "Oh no, no, that's fine. So we have this sort of competitive thing about who's the best rower. I was a rower when I was at university so I think him quite good. But he wasn't having any of it. He rowed us all the way back, about a third of a mile. I was impressed. That's a heavy old boat." In other scenes set to air he is also filmed lifting a water lettuce up to show its sprawling roots. He also used an underwater camera while punting on the River Avon in Wiltshire. Filmed with pioneering technology, the five-part series is split into five different worlds that plants inhabit: tropical worlds, water worlds, seasonal worlds, desert worlds, and human worlds. COVID travel restrictions meant the series, made by BBC Studios' world-renowned Natural History Unit, was filmed over 4 years. David feels that the Green Planet series is timely, especially with biodiversity declining at a rate faster than at any other time in human history. A 2018 study showed that human activity has been responsible for the loss of 83% of the world's wild mammals and 50% of our plants. The world has become plant conscious. There has been a global revolution in attitudes towards the natural world, he reflected previously. "We would starve without plants, we wouldn't be able to breathe without plants. The world is green yet people's understanding about plants, except in a narrow way, has not kept up with that. This will bring it home. It's a cliche now, but every breath of air we take, and every mouthful of food we eat, depends upon plants." He says one of his favorite moments was filming giant sequoias in California for the Seasonal Worlds episode. "They've been there for 3,000 years, yet this was the first time the team had ever filmed them. One of the really great, profoundly moving experiences was to go to these enormous trees," says David. But what this program did was use technical inventions that have changed natural history photography over the past 20 years, drones. "The camera suddenly rises above the treetops and you see these giants. It really is a marvelous sequence." The Green Planet, Sundays, 7 p.m., BBC One.